You plan to get back into a hardcore industry like you did with Facebook ever again?
So I'm at a wedding, and I've had quite an interesting day by far, but something really special has come up, which I'm vlogging on my phone again. It's been a while. But there's someone I'd like to introduce to the vlog, someone who I've admired for a long, long, long time. I didn't know I'd be meeting her today, but it's a big deal.
This is really hard for me to do because I don't really know her personally, so it's kind of awkward to just break in when she's in the middle of a conversation with someone else. I'm sorry to follow her.
Three questions.
Yeah.
You get three questions, make them good.
Okay, which has been your favorite company to work at by far? Facebook, Dropbox, or the
My own startup.
Go. Go.
Yeah.
Before I got inspired by Dropbox.
Correct.
Why did you exit Dropbox?
I had this dream where I wanted to travel for 8 months and the timing just seemed right and then.
Oh, awesome. And you plan to get back into a hardcore industry like you did with Facebook ever again?
I think your career just evolves with time, and like right now I started an incubator and we start a lot of different companies in the incubator. So it's still hardcore, but it's different. It's not the same.
Thank you so much. I'm so sorry to bother you.
Thank you.
It's all I've ever wanted to do in my life. It's all I wanted to do.
Congratulations. I'll be right back.
I'll
see
you.
What?
Your PAN card.
I'll get that done this week.
We need to get that done.
Go Monday, I'll speak to
the CA.
I'll speak to the CA tomorrow. Yeah, registration should be done. I'm at Kush's house today. We're working out of his TV room. That's Kush and Ikram. And I got down to the wedding. I only managed to ask her three questions. I'm not too sure if the audio was clear enough because it was like in a noisy wedding space. Okay, but I've asked the three questions and it was incredible because she not only founded the whole idea of the newsfeed.
$1,100.
No. But anyway, so our company's gonna register this week and we're hopefully launching next week, and we're sitting and designing content for the channel. Like, if you want to know what we're doing, watch this video here. And right now what we're doing is, part of our content is we're going to be doing these high fashion challenges. Like, people do low budget challenges for designing looks. We're doing something of the similar sort, but with high fashion. So we give each of us a budget of $1,100 to compose a look. And we did that last time. It was crazy fun. But this time we're doing the same thing. But yeah, so we all get onto like the internet and we compose like a whole look, start to finish. And this time it's going to be including shoes. It's going to be a lot tougher. And I'm going to put them all out here. Vote for your favorite in the comments below. Look, Kush is done with the look. Ikram, we're waiting on you. You done?
Yeah, fuck, but I'm done.
You done? Okay, let's do this.
Dude, I have to come here.
Just ship, get rid of Kush and ship to the.
Come on, Ikram, you got a minute. Yeah, if you're off, you're fucked. Like, if you're extra, you can just want
to. No, I'm done. By 35.
I'm under by 50.
Rupees. $1. Okay, then you go first.
Okay, you go first until you finish first.
No, you have to go first.
So,
I finish last, I'm going last.
So, first thing. Grey Fjord, I've got an oversized t-shirt, 125. Above that, I want the off-white Cavaggio print hoodie, the Air Jordan 1, and the grey jeans, the grey 2 religion. I want a
plus. So $1,026, Kush is just well under limit. Okay, my look starts with, let's start with the shoes. The Pharrell Williams tennis hue shoes, pink in color, D-squared white pants.
Okay.
Pleated front trousers, the off-white Dior Caravaggio t-shirt.
Caravaggio, yeah.
With a Dolce & Gabbana bomber.
My look starts with, I start from the bottom, which is the Air Jordan Royals, that's $290.
I think I...
Then I go with the ASOS Grey Long Line, because it's cheap. And it does the
nice
same
fit.
Thing. With jeans, I've gone with them. I've gone a minimal LA for £50 on the perfect ribs. Perfect ribs. And
spent a lot on top, matlab.
I've gone with the off-white industrial belt.
I looked at that, but it's so.
And the Balenciaga Ohm sweatshirt.
Mm.
Mm.
Very different from last year.
Yeah.
So I went to the very dark I went very, very dark, like a full black look.
Are you over-accessorizing them?
No.
These earphones that I'm wearing right now are from a company called Brahi. How do you spell it?
Brahi. B-R-A-G-I.
B-R-A-G-A.
B-R-A-G-I.
They're individually wireless, like the AirPods. They come with a super cool case which charges them. And they're completely waterproof. It's insane. You can go swimming with them. And do they have a memory of their own?
Yeah, you can ignore music onto the thing.
And they have a memory of their own. It's like a computer in themselves. And you can control them by touching on them. It's like an interactive touchscreen. And they have a...
Look at this. Audio transfer.
Cool app.
Talk, you can hear yourself clearer now.
They have this super cool feature called transparency. Basically, the idea is since they're so sound isolating themselves, with the hit of a button on the app, it activates a microphone which basically frees sound to go through, and now I can basically hear myself a lot better. This is insane.
There's also an option for this thing called windshield, which basically if there's too much wind noise coming in, you turn windshield and that cuts out the wind sound.
Oh. Okay, I'm back home. It's been a great career day. Comment down below whose outfit you like the most. I'm going to compose them down in order. You can check them out. Tell me what you think of them. Again, we're not dressing. We're not shopping like this yet. It's an aspiration, of course. At one day, I wish I could, every day where I could be like that. But we want to, basically with street culture, we want to make, improve the image of street fashion as high fashion. You know what I'm saying? As in, unfortunately, the only way the mass market sees street fashion is through mass market brands like Zara and H&M and stuff like that. Nothing wrong. They bring really high fashion trends down to a mass market. But they lose their high fashion back. I don't know if that makes sense yet. But one day it will. And that's the day we will be successful. But that's about it. Otherwise, it's been a fire-ass day. At the wedding, I also ended up meeting a mentor that we've been looking for street culture. That's why I love these fancy-ass events with all these fancy people, because networking works out so well at these places. I met a dude who's currently working with startups as a mentor, as an investor, stuff like that. Basically specializes in retail, which is huge, because that's exactly what we've been looking for to help us out. And he's got us a sick plug with someone high up in a very big company, which I'll tell you guys about later. But that's about it for today, guys. Thank you for watching. I'm sorry for being so short. Not really that much content, but that's about it for today. Thank you for... That's about it. Thank you for watching. Good night.